Well, hello, kids. Mayor Rick Chrest here, and in our continuing series of books that I'm reading to students, because I know that you're all doing your best at home to keep up with your studies and your own reading and maybe helping out around the house a little bit. And since I can't come into your schools and hook up with you, I thought I would do a few books online that you could all read. And these are from our own personal household collection that we used to read to our own kids. So here's another Robert Munsch story, artwork by Michael Marchenko, and it's a classic called The Paper Bag Princess. Elizabeth was a beautiful princess. She lived in a castle and had expensive princess clothes. She was going to marry a prince named Ronald. Unfortunately, a dragon smashed her castle, burned all her clothes with his fiery breath, and carried off Prince Ronald. Elizabeth decided to chase the dragon and get Ronald back. She looked everywhere for something to wear, but the only thing she could find was not burnt was a paper bag. So she put on the paper bag and followed the dragon. He was easy to follow, because he left a trail of burnt forests and horses' bones. Finally, Elizabeth came to a cave with a large door that had a huge knocker on it. She took hold of the knocker and banged on the door. The dragon stuck his nose out of the door and said, "Well, a princess, I love to eat princesses, but I have already eaten a whole castle today. I am a very busy dragon. Come back tomorrow." He slammed the door so fast that Elizabeth almost got her nose caught. Elizabeth grabbed the knocker and banged on the door again. The dragon stuck his nose out of the door and said, "Go away. I love to eat princesses, but I've already eaten a whole castle today. I'm a very busy dragon. Come back tomorrow." "Wait," shouted Elizabeth. "Is it true that you are the smartest and fiercest dragon in the whole world?" "Yes," said the dragon. "Is it true," said Elizabeth, "that you can burn up 10 forests with your fiery breath?" "Oh, yes," said the dragon, and he took a huge deep breath and breathed out so much fire that he burnt up 50 forests. "Fantastic," said Elizabeth, and the dragon took another huge breath and breathed out so much fire that he burnt up 100 forests. "Magnificent," said Elizabeth. And the dragon took another huge breath, but this time nothing came out. The dragon didn't even have enough fire left to cook a meatball. Elizabeth said, "Dragon, is it true that you can fly around the world in just 10 seconds? "Why, yes," said the dragon, and jumped up and flew all the way around the world in just 10 seconds. He was very tired when he got back, but Elizabeth shouted, "Fantastic! Do it again!" So the dragon jumped up and flew around the world in just 20 seconds. When he got back, he was too tired to talk, and he lay down and went straight to sleep. Elizabeth whispered very softly, "Hey, dragon." The dragon didn't move at all. She lifted up the dragon's ear and put her head right inside. She shouted as loud as she could, "Hey, dragon." The dragon was so tired he didn't even move. Elizabeth walked right over the dragon and opened the door to the cave. There was Prince Ronald. He looked at her and he said, "Elizabeth, you are a mess. You smell like ashes, and your hair is all tangled, and you are wearing a dirty old paper bag. Come back when you're dressed like a real princess." "Ronald," said Elizabeth, "your clothes are really pretty, and your hair is very neat. You look like a real prince, but you are a bum." They didn't get married after all. That's the end. That's a classic, interesting story about the paper bag princess, and Elizabeth sure showed him after she saved him and he was so rude to her. So I hope you enjoyed that one. Tune in to some of the other books that we've put online, and I hope you're all doing well at home, keeping up with your studies. Help around the house a little bit if you can. And everybody, stay well.